All right, I'm Scott, and we're here doing a 10 street basis coilover install on a 2013 Hyundai Genesis Coupe 2.0 Turbo.
We are going to be removing the shock spring. Mainly you will need a 12, 14, 17, and 19, which I have here. First thing you want to do is remove the brake line so you don't rip that. It is a 12 millimeter. Very easy to do. Even Scott could do it. Put all my bolts back in their holes so we don't lose those. Now, for the lower bolts on the shock, it is a 17 on one side, 19 on the other. Then you're going to need your 17 to hold the other side. You can use a wrench or a socket. You have the right sizes. This should only take about 5 minutes. Don't lose your sockets like I did. Your bolts, get that out in a minute. Take you a hammer, bump the bolts out lightly, not to swell them. Brake line's free. And the bottom should be loose. Get our little find where my I'll get that out in a minute. Then top 14 millimeter. If you want to get that on video, we're gonna remove the top of the shock tower. There is a cap that you need to pop off ahead of time. Careful not to scratch any paint. 3 14 millimeter bolts. I usually undo two, and then as I'm doing the third, I hold the shock so it doesn't come popping down, ripping brake lines. Or yeah, if you would like to hold that, you can, sir. We definitely don't want to rip nothing. That's pretty much all there is to actually getting it out of the car. It's pretty simple. You got it?
Yeah.
Just kind of wiggle. And it should pop right in. Oh, you're pulling out on. Don't pull out.
Oh, it's the sway bar.
Oh, yep. See? And then you got to do the sway bar, which is a 17 millimeter. Let's see. Straighten this back up. It probably would have been easier to do that first, but I was distracted. Sway bars will be replaced. Now, you will need a 18 millimeter to hold the back of the sway bar. Like so. Once I bump this out, it will come free. Now I'm going to take a little hammer and just tap on the sway bar there. Out. Now we should be able to drop that right down. It's hanging on the threads, but there we go. That is your strut and spring out. And now you will need a spring compressor. Yeah. Spring compressor, you're pretty much adding one to either side, and you need an external spring compressor for this model. Some are internal for V8s and some imports. This one will be an external. You're going to tighten it down. You usually want to find two center springs, because once you pinch it, you don't want this to get pinched in there. So you try to make sure it's, you know, not going to get locked in once you tighten it. I get everything in place. Take a little adjusting a couple times so you get this tight. Well, this is a 17 millimeter. I'm sorry, 19 millimeter. Once you have tension out of it, just get it kind of tight on there. Take your 19 millimeter. Now you won't want to just do one at a time, because it's going to put it in a bind. So you want to do one at a time. Just do a couple turns. Go back to your other side. Do a couple turns and keep doing that back and forth until you get tension off the cap, the top hat. And once this freely spins, you know you've got tension off of it. Now before we get full tension off of it, because I had problems on the other side, we're going to put our 17 back on, and we are going to loosen this bolt. I'm sorry, that's a 19 too. So 19 millimeter for the top. Well, maybe it's not. I'm sorry, it is a 17. I apologize. All right. Yeah, we're going to have to hold it. If I could get a hand here, Scott. Come here, Tyler. Hold that right there, buddy.
It's over there.
Yep. Just let me make sure. There we go. I appreciate it, buddy. All right. That's all I need. Now, we are going to put the 19 back on and finish compressing the spring. This is a safety issue. If you were not to use a spring compressor, this spring could fly off and damage property, hurt someone. Once this cap spins a little bit, you know you've got tension off. There you go, spinning. You know you've got the tension off of it now. 17 back on. Release your bolt. It might pop a little bit. Being then we compress the spring, it's not going to go far. that's it. Remove your cap, pull your strut out, and then you want to put your 19 back on and release your spring. The top hat, the reason we removed it, it will go on the teen coilovers. It required using the factory top hat. And then also, you have to remove a rubber piece from the factory top hat, where we will be replacing it with teen's aluminum seat. And this creates, so it sits properly on the teen coilovers. If you try to use this one, it had a little bend, a little cock to it. And you want it to sit flush so you don't end up with noise or any ride problems. And in 1 second we'll have this back apart, and then I can seat the other one. Get the strut ready for me. Almost done. All right. A little bit of turning here.
Yeah, I'm gonna fast forward. I'm gonna speed it up to this.
Yeah, I don't want this.
That's a minute and a half.
Yeah, I'm just twisting a ball.
This is how Gary works the ratchet.
This is.
He got a big forearm. Not just for.
It's from working on cars.
Not just from. It's not just used for. car work.
Lonely time.
Yeah.
That's for choking the monkey, you know. All right. Now, if you're using teen, this is how you would set it up. You use your factory nut washer. You're gonna take your aluminum ring seats inside the coilover like so. Your top hat, make sure everything looks good, nothing's messed up. There is a bearing inside here. You always wanna make sure that's not messed up. Everything looks good. You can take it, spin it on here. Now you're gonna have a little play in it because these are our lowering springs. You can push it down and see that everything seats though. I usually like to check it. You wanna put your washer on. If you do not use a washer, you can end up with this popping through over the nut because there is a rubber seal under there. So once you put your washer on, you can spin your nut on. Now being that this nut sits inside of a hole here, normally you can put an Allen wrench or something on there, but these we will be kind of using a cheater. We will hold it with a pair of pliers, a lesson we learned on the other side. Take your 17 millimeter. You just want to snug that bolt down. Yeah. There you go, squeeze, buddy. Slipped up there. That is a 17 and I'm using a 19. That would explain the problem. Alright. That new bolt's a little stiff at first. You do want to make sure it's tight though because you don't want any play. Almost there. Let's see. Yep, it's seating. I don't feel it tight yet, it's a little stiff, but there we go. Alright, that's tight. Now, that's how it'll look when it's done. And once again, you can push down on the strut, see that everything is seated properly. Now, we will be replacing the sway bar arm. There are sway bar arms with it, so we want to go ahead and put the new one on. Let's locate that. Now to remove the old one, there's a 17 millimeter bolt in the bottom. It will be crawling under here to remove this. It just makes it easier. ratchet set the right way. I'm gonna have to get to the front of the vehicle anyway. You can probably see it better. Same way it came out. Put your nut back on. You will have to hold this one to tighten it back up with the 18, the same as you did to take that one off. Scott, can I get a hand for one minute, please?
Here's your bolts.
Can I get this over there? Just slide one of those on. Okay. Now I may have to spin this. Let me see this way. Is it right? All right, all three coming through?
Yeah, spin it just a little bit.
Let me see. I can't see.
He's going to the right.
There you go. Here, just get one bolt on, and then I'll wiggle it in place. And then you can sit here and put these brackets around. Let's get this bolt on, and then I'll wiggle that one in place. Watch your fingers. Yeah, that's fingers dirty. Let's loosen this bolt back up. If it goes on even. Well, hand me that rubber mallet right there. Always use rubber. You don't want to beat on this with metal. There you go. Now, so you can see well. Make sure this brake line is not hung up like that. Slide your sway bar arm in. Put your nut on it, which is right here. And that is a 17 millimeter nut. We'll go ahead and just kind of set that in place. We'll tighten that in a minute. Brake line, we need to pull the bolt. Factory bolt is here. This holds your brake line. We'll put that on in 1 second. It's kind of sitting out. I don't want it to be ripped. Now, slide your hub assembly up, and you can normally just kind of hold it in place. Take your bolts, put your 17 millimeter on one side, 19 millimeter nuts. Slide through. Slide your second one through. 19 millimeter nuts. The 19 millimeter bolt on. Kind of threw me off because we had an extra 17 from the factory shop. Alright. 19 millimeter, 17 millimeter wrench. I like to get them both snug and then I go back and tighten them. You know, whenever you lose, tighten one all the way, you might have problems with the other one. Just something I've learned over the years. Get everything in place first. once everything is in place. You want to go ahead and make sure these are real tight because you do not want these coming loose. Remove this bolt that we had in there. There's a little clip on it. You want that to seat at the bottom. That prevents the brake line from twisting. If the brake line twists, it can make your brakes feel like they're being pressed all the time. That's one of the reasons that bracket is there. Snug that, make sure it's locked in place like it's supposed to be. Hold your brake line until it's tight because you don't want that to twist at all. Once it is tight, you can go ahead and tighten that. All right. Make sure our dust shield hasn't got bent out of place anywhere. We don't want that rubbing brakes. 14 millimeter. And we will tighten the top because we left that a little loose. You don't want to over tighten them, they can break. Everything. I like to put my hands on every single bolt. Reminds me that I tightened it. The adjustment is fine. We'll probably be checking it and adjusting that in a minute, but we just want to get everything in place. All right, and we can put the top. A 17 and a 14 and a 19 wrench to remove the shock and the spring. First thing we are going to loosen is the shock, and that is a 19 millimeter socket. Releases the top. Socket is best. Now we need to release the sway bar, 17 millimeter, and we're going to release that so the lower swing arm can go down. Jack it up. Now we're going to undo the lower control arm from the hub assembly, and that'll be a 19 millimeter. And you need a wrench. Take some of this pressure off so it doesn't fly down. Before we do that, we're going to pull the brake line clip out just to make sure that we don't pull the brake line. Make sure that's free. Well, insert the spring on the teen coilovers. Coil goes to the top. You got a piece of plastic here that keeps the spring from rubbing against the aluminum. So coil up, spring, plastic in the center. It's going to seat. If you see, you have a rubber boot here. There's actually a groove here that this piece of the spring is going to sit in. So you want to make sure that you get the spring in that groove, which will make it sit properly. Now you may have to take something and actually pry down. Once you do, make sure that's seated properly. Slide that into place. Then move on to putting your bolts in the top.